We have the magnetic field lines inside in one direction, outside it's going back in the other. Then we have first 3 layers of pixels in silicon, and then we have 10 layers of silicon strips. So that's a whole inner tracking system. Cylinder 6 meter long, 2 meter 40 in diameter, 200 square meters of silicon detectors. And that's to reconstruct the tracks of the charged particles. It's similar to the chip you have in your camera. Now imagine the particles have more energy, you can put a second chip behind and still measure it, and a third. So it's like an onion, you have this shell-like structure to make three-dimensional pictures of the particles entering the detector. And then afterwards you have the calorimeters to measure the energy. So these are the crystals, 80,000 altogether, as we have seen in the vitrine. Mm-hmm. That's the electromagnetic calorimeter, and then we have the hydronic calorimeter in brass, with slits and scintillators for the readout of the shower. And then outside, the 4 layers of muon detectors. So that's basically what we have seen, because everything else is hidden inside. Now what happens if, for example, a muon is produced in the collision? The muon can go through the whole detector, it's bended inside in one direction and outside in the other, outside of the magnet. And then from the bending, you can determine the charge and the momentum of the muon. And if you have, for example, an electron, you have also a central track, but it loses all its energy in the crystals of the electromagnetic calorimeter. And if you have a charged hadron, like a proton, for example, it loses only a fraction of its energy in the crystals and gets only completely stopped in the brass of the hadronic calorimeter. And if you have a neutral hadron, like a neutron, for example, you don't see a central track. That we see only for charged particles. They make ionization in the silicon detectors, and other particles we don't see there. Then you can have a photon, for example. Again, that loses all its energy in the crystals of the electromagnetic calorimeter. So in this way, we can distinguish the different kinds of particles.